Okay. Apparently we crashed. But you guys should, you see me now, right? Hey, dear Bart, welcome. Oh, that is great. That's great. I don't know why OBS decided to crash, but it's gonna be a nice cut in the cut in half video. Typical. Okay, the weird experimental fur brush kind of worked. I mean, it's not nothing amazing. Definitely. I got a few brushes that I like to use with fur. This one as well. It's like a really dirty brush, but it makes really nice. It's like you have a dry traditional media brush, and you can kind of fade with it. I really like it. I don't remember who made it, but it's really nice as well for fur. And I have another one that I mix with other brushes, which is this one, which is like a rake, and the brush itself is just like dots. But it also gives a nice like broken lines, so you can create rugged areas. I like it. It's great for breaking up a hard brush. Like if you spent a lot of time with a hard brush, that sounded dirty. If you spend a lot of time with your hard brush, no, but when you construct the form a lot with the hard brush, it becomes very telltale. You know, you can spot it. So having a textured brush that you go over some of the marks with to make it smooth. It works really well. Scary, yeah. Usually though, like if you have it like a two row setup like this, the brushes, most of them at top is what I use. The other ones down, further down, I use very seldom. But there's like a selection at the top which I use a lot for painting with. Hey, Captain Jetlag, what up? What up, yo? Yeah. When I was little, there was this similar one, like not blind, but that you grow hair inside your hand, that you get hair inside your hand. I don't know why, but that was the one I heard. Like, oh, that's messed up. I don't want hair growing inside my palm. Never heard that word? Yeah. The blind one, I think, is like universal. We're 10 minutes left. To iced coffee? I also used to drink iced coffee when I was a child. Yeah, this guy is—he has a coffee bath. Let's make small pupils, you know, so he's full on in cocaine land. Captain Jetlag. Yeah, it's a six-leg Tarsier for sure. I'm gonna try an experiment. I want to see how it works. We're gradient map, night vision. Nah, not gonna do night vision. Even though it's a cool idea, let's just see how it looks with night vision. There we go. Here's night vision. But anyways. The thing I'm gonna try is to kind of find if you look at horses have like what's it called? There's a very specific way that there is banding. That looks pretty dope, even though it's not what I'm going for. It didn't really do what I wanted it to do. But horses have like, what's it called? Isotropic shading? Is that what it's called? It doesn't reflect light normally, like it bands the light. I don't remember what the name was. So like if you write, for example, a shader for a horse, you gotta, it has to behave in a specific way. Yeah, they have high specularity for sure, but it's called a specific way, like how it goes, the banding doesn't go, let's say a sphere, it goes, the highlight goes to the tip of the thing that's pointing towards the light source. But like for horses, they have circles. Anisotropic, yeah. There we go. crazy stuff. I knew it because I was working on a game many years ago where they wrote a horse shader, and they came and asked me, like, what the, like, why does the horse look wrong? And we did research, and we were like, oh yeah, that's the reason. Yeah, it's tricky. This is turning out really weird, but I like it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, same for hair. Like, you can see, maybe my hair isn't that shiny, but it creates, like, bands of highlights. Hey, who wants to play drink the beer? Right here. Hey, Team Remmers. Right. What do I win? Another beer. Welcome to the end. This is the end, my only friend, the end. Tim Remmers, I'm serenading you with This Is The End song. It's my own, not at all a Doors song. Paid no attention to the Doors, they stole from me. Yeah. Welcome everyone from Tim Remmers' stream. You're joining in at the very end of my 30-minute warm-up, where I today have taken the randomly picked topic of Tarsier, and made it into a creature. I love you, some happy endings. They are the best kind. Hey, Gria, what up, yo? Dear Bard, maybe not. I don't know. I mean, I know that a lot of with the feathers is due to oil. They are their natural oil. They coat their wings in natural oil to stick the feathers together. And when they're sick or dry or dirty, that's where they mess up the balance, and they have issues. But if it's the same shader, not sure. Thank you very much, Tim Remmers. Thank you very much, Gria. Yeah, it's some weird little monster here. And you've definitely missed, Gria. Now that you're here, the world is as it should be. Oh, look at this. The things you get for free if you use layers efficiently. Oh. All right. Emanuelo 42. Thank you very much for the follow, man. Thank you very much for the auto host, Sam Peterson. Even though you are not here, sir. Booker Studios. I think he would. I think I also would like to see that interaction. Like, imagine a movie with Bobby Chu's creatures like scallivanting on a field, like, and then this one comes down from the tree, like slowly creeping in shadows, like with a head on a swivel, kind of eyeballing the Bobby Chu creature, and then with night vision type eyes, you know, it's transfixed on the Bobby Chu creature, and then another set of eyes, then another set of eyes, then another set of eyes, then they're just kind of like piranhas attacking, eating the little fat Bobby Chu bunny. Hey, Dark Miu, thank you very much for the follow. Much appreciated. Friday the 13th, the creature version. Yeah, man. We should, like, to make him extra, like, twitchy, just bring one eyelid up. So he's like full on Twitch. Yeah, man, you don't want to steal his berry. the crackhead Tarsier, yeah. All right, that's it for the stream. Thank you for people to joining in from the raid. Unfortunately, what is going to have to happen is that I have to end the stream. But I just don't end it. I raid another happy camper. So let's have a look at the creative section. That looks pretty cute. It's traditional day. Usually, though, what happens is that I try to find something and it's just a bunch of tits and ass everywhere. Today is pretty good, actually. I am impressed, creative. I am impressed. Not so much tits and ass everywhere. 1 hour background study. Alright. What's this? King of Humans, we're raiding King of Humans. We're doing isometric interior because you guys have interior to do at 2 week challenge. King of Humans. Kirill, I don't like to support that tits and ass. It's a bit cheap. You can do it. I'm not hating on people doing it. But I don't want to support it, really. Thanks, everyone, for coming. Have a fantastic day. Much love. Thank you all for the follows, the raids. All you cool people, come to by tomorrow again. Bye.